The effects of the COVID-19 pandemic have meant restrictions and suffering for many, but even if they didn't get sick, children and young students might be one of the age groups affected the most by the long-term impacts. At an age when it is especially important for development to have real-world interactions with other humans, many schools have had to shift entirely to distance learning. The required laptops and tablets are often issued by the schools themselves, and students usually have little say in what comes pre-installed. Anyone who is no longer in school might have no idea that since even long before the pandemic, an entire industry has developed not only for providing digital learning tools, but also for monitoring and tracking students even outside the school. Here are some examples of student surveillance. Some schools, especially in the United States, install surveillance cameras in school halls and classrooms. In New York, several public schools spend millions of dollars on face recognition technology to prevent school shootings, despite little evidence of its effectiveness. Contrary to many truly public spaces, these students have no choice but to be subjected to being filmed, tracked, and analyzed if they want to attend school. For similar reasons, hundreds of schools are deploying so-called aggression detectors, small microphones installed along the ceiling of hallways and common areas. A specialized software is supposed to detect aggression in a person's voice and then sends automatic notifications to teachers or security personnel. One company selling these devices offers add-on packages for recognizing gunshots, car alarms, or broken glass. Another even advertises sensors to detect vaping students in the school bathrooms. These types of privacy invasions happen on school property, but it doesn't stop there. Digital devices are an even easier and cheaper way to monitor students. School-issued tablets are often capable of tracking their Wi-Fi connections and location through GPS. Schools have used this and other data, like contactless chips in ID cards and bus passes, for attendance tracking and consequently assigning detention. Many schools and universities require students to install a security certificate to use the school Wi-Fi, even with personal devices. While the usage of these certificates can have perfectly valid reasons, they can also be used to monitor browser history or messages. Companies like GoGuardian sell software for school staff to view and screenshot students' computer screens, control their browsers, see their browsing history, and collect data patterns from a student's webcam, keyboard, and microphone to identify misbehavior. Up until 2015, GoGuardian was even able to lock keystrokes and remotely activate student webcams, but the company has removed this particular feature since then. One product called GoGuardian Beacon monitors online activity on school-issued computers in real time and tries to predict so-called concerning activity. This could, for example, mean interest in guns and bombs, cyberbullying, or mental health issues like self-harm. The software notifies school staff or the parents when it finds behavior it deems alarming. Online exams are often overseen by remote exam supervision software like Respondus or Proctorio. These programs lock down a student's computer so only allowed applications and websites are accessible. The participants are constantly recorded through their webcam, and their behavior is monitored for cheating attempts by automated software. This not only includes screen recording and web traffic logging, but also video and audio analysis of the room the exam is taken in, and tracking of eye as well as head movements of the student to detect any suspicious glances. Depending on the company and the specific software product, the student recordings are first reviewed by a professional third-party review team, which reports any incidents to the teacher. Jenny Jephardt from the Electronic Frontier Foundation criticizes that being under constant surveillance from an early age teaches kids to accept that people they should trust are spying on them. The EFF created a surveillance self-defense guide for students, which is linked below. One of the most important points is to first of all broach the issue in the first place and talk about it with friends and trusted adults. They also recommend to not use school-provided technology in the first place, if possible. Numerous examples document a so-called chilling effect by surveillance, which describes self-censorship or changed behavior when people are aware of being observed. Acclimating students to extensive surveillance could have significant consequences for their adult life, for example, in dealing with abusive romantic partners or employers. Thanks for watching, and a special thank you to the SensiClick Patreon supporters. I'll see you in the next video.